thing from feed rate to x51.6.
So here's the finished result, uncoated. I'm doing this shot in 4K, but it'll probably be trimmed down to 1080p by the time all the other video clips are included. So I will try to get this as close as possible. Hopefully it's clear. You can see a bunch of the spots in the dark, hopefully. See them a lot more down here as well, where it started to happen again. There's a patch in the middle where I didn't have any pauses, but each little black kind of dot there is where it paused. Problem with the universal G-code sender that I was having. So I'm going to have to look at another way to send the code to the machine. Some of these panels are obviously not very square. So there's a edge up here, edge down here. But otherwise it turned out great. I'm gonna have to get a coating on it. Probably gonna get some go down to Michael's and get some more epoxy to do a glaze coat, but it turned out very well. And this is just an artist panel, dollar store artist panel. This is all the test runs that I think I started here. Trying to do a gradient and a bunch of different test patterns. A couple more was having all kinds of problems with the laser at a higher power. And then I got to this point and I was trying to bring the white a little closer. And I got here. And I felt pretty good about that one, so that's about where the settings are right now. I went a little bit farther, and as soon as I hit the laser to 60%, boom, black. So I wasn't getting a clean gradient anymore. So as soon as I hit that 60% mark, I'm getting a whole lot more intensity with the laser. I need to speed up the machine to overcome that, so this here was kind of the sweet spot. That's where I stuck. Problem is, I left the resolution on high, and it took about four times longer than it really should have. So there you go. Laser Tiger. I do not own the art. Would like to get a hold of the guy, though. Not selling, not monetized here on YouTube. So yeah, just kind of a test piece to make sure the machine went well. But cheers.